Homo sapiens, we've been on this planet for 300,000 years. And during that time, we ate protein as the primary source of our sustenance. Now, how do I know this? Well, number one is, if you take a look at the body, you can see that the body is made to digest protein. If you start with your teeth, we have canine teeth. Those canine teeth are meant for cutting and chewing meat. If you take a look at our gastrointestinal system, particularly our stomach is designed to digest meat. If you take a look at the stomach of animals that were not designed to eat meat, for instance, some grazers and things like that, they have a completely different gastroenterological system, which is designed to digest plants. Ours isn't. Ours is meant to digest meat, protein sources such as meat. The other thing I wanted to talk to you about is our brains. If you take a look at our brains, they are very similar to other predatory brains. And that is, our brains have evolved to help us capture protein sources. So, one little tidbit I like to give people about the white potatoes. We talk about this all the time in my practice because I think white potatoes are basically poison. What they are is pure carbohydrate, pure energy. And if you're in a famine, that's wonderful. But in our society where there's calories all around us, we're literally surrounded by calories, we don't need the extra calories. Adult onset diabetes started on this planet at the same point in history that the potato was cultivated. And if you take a look at the spread of the cultivation of potatoes, you'll see that it's a linear relationship with the increase in diabetes in the world. That, to me, is great evidence that you really want to stay away from potatoes. Not that I don't like them, and not that you can't have them once in a while. So before we get on to exercise, I wanted to say a couple more words about diet, and that is, the word diet should be changed with lifestyle. I don't want you to do these things for 2 weeks or 3 weeks. I want you to do these things for the rest of your life. And in order to help you to do that, the best way is to allow you to cheat once in a while. I myself favor the low carbohydrate or paleo diet. And you know, I tell people I'm on a modified paleo diet. My wife will get a kick out of this when she listens. Hopefully she's going to listen. But I do, I modify it. Every once in a while, I allow myself to have some starch. And the whole idea is that, or some sugars. I'm trying to stay on the program over the long term. I'm trying to get the majority of my calories from the paleo diet, and every once in a while cheat so that I stay on the program for the long term. I'm a big sucker for rhubarb pie, and when my rhubarb is ripe, I love to make a rhubarb pie, and it doesn't fit onto the diet that I've been talking to you about. But a piece of rhubarb pie here, a piece of pizza there. In general, stay on, get the bulk of your calories from a high protein, low starch diet, and you're going to ultimately get down to the weight you want to. You have to keep on it over time. Again, we talked about the speed with which you should lose weight. If you lose weight slowly, the weight will stay off. If you lose weight fast, not only is it going to come back, but you're going to put more on afterwards. So keep those things in mind. Again, it's a lifestyle change. It's not it's not 2 or 3 months here. It's doing these things over the long term. So, exercise. I hope to talk about exercise in an upcoming program. And I did want to mention that if you have any suggestions for me in terms of programs that we like to talk about on Your Health Matters, please let me know. The best way to do that is to email me on my website, which is peter@peterhogenkamp.com. And let me know of a subject you're interested in learning more about. I happen to be a huge exercise advocate, as many of my patients will tell you. And I could sit here and talk about the benefits of exercise for a long time. I'm not going to do that because we're going to save that for another show. However, the depressing the depression index here is pretty high in exercise because mild to moderate exercise rarely results in weight loss on its own. And I'm going to repeat that because it's worth repeating. Mild to moderate exercise rarely results in weight loss in and of itself. And that's because exercise stimulates your appetite. When you exercise, you eat more. And what happens is, and this has been shown in studies, that